is not a sponge is no ordinary sponge. And as a matter of fact, I want you to take a look at this sponge. So they're convenient. They're great to wash our dishes, our pots, and our pans.
But why are they different?
I'll tell you why they're different. My sponges inhibit the growth of mold and bacteria on the sponge, in the sponge, for the life of the sponge.
Say it again.
My sponges inhibit, they don't allow the growth of mold and bacteria in or on the sponge for the life of the sponge.
Isn't that amazing?
Without chemicals. And what are the kinds of things we're talking about? We're talking about things like that it inhibits the growth of is Staph, MRSA, E. coli, Salmonella, black mold, all those horrible, icky things. I'm going to take you to the sink for just a moment, and then we're going to come back and talk to you more about what this does. Okay. There have been so many studies done about what's the dirtiest place in your house. Most people would say their bathroom. The germiest place, forget it. It's your kitchen sink. That is the worst. And what do you keep behind your kitchen sink?
Guilty!
That horrible, crispy critter of a horrible thing. Instead, you want to have my sponges available for you to use every single day. Now, come back to the table with us because we're going to show you the science of what my sponges are about. Remember, I'm the science girl. I know the science of keeping things fresh, clean. Look at this animation. This is done by the independent test. See that? That's an animation depicting what is growing on your current cellulose sponge. That is disgusting. And they multiply. They keep going. They don't stop. On my sponge, you might pick something up, and there it is, but it cannot live because it cannot reproduce. So you see things disappearing on the sponge? That's because it inhibits the growth and multiplication
That's
of those
awesome.
Horrible things. So have here, look, just look here for a moment. Look at the difference. This little crater filled with things and food particles and whatever, my sponge. We're going to get rid of that. My sponge is soft. It's easy to hold. My name is on it. You don't like my name? Turn it over. it'll wear off eventually anyway. This sponge, you use it until it shreds, and that's a long time for me.
And you get 12 of them, by the way.
Now let me tell you about 12 of my sponges. Each of my sponges holds 22 times its own weight and absorbs 40% more liquid than an ordinary sponge, and you'll get 12. Now guess what? Every one of my sponges will last 15 times longer than an ordinary sponge.
Wow.
So let me give you a little visual, okay? If you buy 12 of my sponges, you don't have to buy...
Good gracious.
180 ordinary sponges. That's what you say.
Well, no wonder these are always so successful. I mean, think about it.
My sponge...
That's years of sponges that you never have to worry about buying once you make this one investment tonight.
Look at this side by side. 12 sponges
or
180 sponges. Come on, let's look at it side by side. You want to see the comparison?
And these are sponges that don't inhibit the growth of the bacteria, okay? Because we know that they recommend that we have to put these in the microwave, we have to put them in the dishwasher. I mean, they're just hard to keep clean. You never have to worry about that with the Debbie Meyer Genius Sponge. If you will come on in, remember, head over to our website. It really is the fastest way to get your order in. We still have a lot of you shopping with us for the ultralight green boxes. We want to encourage you to keep your calls coming. But we have very, very limited quantities in the sponges. So we don't have as many as we do in some of the other products. So I do hope that you'll have a chance to get your order in as early as possible. So never having to worry about it. I mean, that's what's brilliant about it. Inhibits the growth of bacteria,
mold,
yucky stuff that we traditionally find in these sponges.
Okay. Now, what are you doing? When you have this sponge and it's got all kinds of things growing in it because nothing is inhibiting their growth, every time you wash something, you're spreading all of that stuff, whether it's to your utensils, it's your kids' toys, it's the dishes, it's my green boxes, it's the baby high chair that you want to clean up because they've just had dinner, right? You don't want to do that. When you use my sponge, because it is inhibiting the growth of those horrible things, you are not spreading. You cut down on the chance that you are going to infect these things with those growths.
And you said that we can use the same detergents that we normally use.
Whatever you use.
Okay.
Whatever, any soap, any dishwashing detergent. Now, what happens is, at night, usually I just rinse my sponge clean. I put it next to my sink, let it dry. And in the morning, it's virtually having a new sponge every day. And that's 15 times longer than any other sponge that you're using. We're going to have a look at the tape again that was made by the independent lab that tested my sponge material. That is what an ordinary cellulose sponge would be growing on it at any given time. And if you're looking at that and you've got one of those next to your sink, hurry over there now and throw it away.
Yes.
With my sponge there, you're going to look right now at the surface of that sponge. Anything that it might pick up can't grow. It inhibits the growth of molds and bacteria. And we're talking about molds and bacteria, including things like MRSA, staph, salmonella, E. coli. That's why your kitchen sink is so bad. Your kitchen sink contains the things that you've put in it, like maybe you rinsed off a chicken. Maybe you threw something in there from meat. You've got things in there that you don't even realize. But I use my sponges all around the house. These absorb so much liquid. I use them in the bathroom because I know I'm not spreading around things. I use them in every room. I put one in my son's gym bag because when he goes there and actually he wipes down things for himself. This is what I put in all the homes of all of my kids, and especially the ones that have grandchildren, because I don't want my grandchildren sitting in a high chair that I'm cleaning with this thing,
right.
This filthy, disgusting thing. I want them cleaning with this. I have people who've told me they're now using them in restaurants. They're using them in nursing homes because, you know what? I'm not a germaphobe. I'm not somebody who's like terrified of every kind of germ. I want to do the best I can with what I've got. This gives you the opportunity to live a little cleaner, a little safer,
But we all have to worry about the spreading of germs, and especially like you talked about, especially in the kitchen area.
And more economical, you know? For heaven's sakes. If 12 of my sponges means you don't have to buy 180 ordinary cellulose sponges. I used to throw away a sponge a week because I didn't know what else to do. It looked horrible, it smelled, all those things. So I would throw away a sponge every week. That really adds up quickly. My sponges last 15 times longer than any one of these sponges would have if I held on to it long enough to look like that horrible one. They are soft the time. They will never become
crispy. Debbie, look.
Oh, God.
You don't even want to touch it.
No.
And the look of this is not, it's not unusual. I mean,
I'm surprised you're touching it.
Barely. But you can see the difference. So
mine will always remain soft. They will never become a crispy critter.
I love that they're super absorbent.
Super, super absorbent. They hold 22 times its own weight in liquid and absorbs 40% more than one of these. 40% more. So if you're wiping up a spill with this, okay, you wipe it up, you squeeze it out, you wipe it up, you squeeze it out. With mine, you want to hear a sound? I'm going to do this and see if you can pick it up. Listen to this. You hear the squeak? That's how dry it is.
Yes.
And I usually just put it down on the liquid and push, and it'll stop it.
As soon as I met with Debbie, and she mentioned to me about the sponges, the fact that they inhibit the growth of bacteria and salmonella and E. coli
and all these other kinds of molds
and bacteria that are out there, I said, why wouldn't you do something like this?
It's so easy.
It's one decision, right? It's going to replace 180 sponges, so obviously now you don't have to worry about replacing them as often because it's just better quality. Now you don't have to worry about all the icky stuff that we're all concerned with spreading the germs and bacteria in our kitchen. You never have to worry about it again because it can't grow on the inside or the outside of this. So if you'd like to have it, I have to just let you know it's very, very limited. We don't have enough for another presentation. I mean, we have so many people on the phone lines for this. Try them. Maybe you are germaphobic. You talked about that you're not, but a lot of people are,
You know, I figure you have to do the best you can with what you got.
Right.
I'm giving you the best I could give you in terms of a little bit healthier, a little bit safer in your home. This, to me, is nothing. I mean, look at the nooks and crannies. At the very least, it's going to capture food particles.
But it's what we can't see, the things that are growing those,
But remember that first of all, my sponge is extremely dense. That's one thing. But that is not the reason that it is inhibiting the growth. It's the construction of the sponge and it's the elements in the sponge, which are natural elements. This is not a chemical. It's not infused with any kind of chemical and it will never wear out. The effectiveness stays there. It's like my green boxes. As long as you own it, as long as you're using it, it is effective.
And so we don't have to put these in the microwave.
No,
we don't have to put these in the dishwasher.
Absolutely not. What I do every night is I actually just
rinse
run it underwater and I let it dry. And in the morning, I feel so good knowing that I have a sponge that smells nice, doesn't have that stinky stale odor. It is still soft, and it continues to inhibit the growth of molds and bacteria and keeps me, you know, I like to feel a little bit safer, a little bit cleaner, whatever it is.
Oh, we all do.
And whether you use it at your sink, your kitchen sink for your dishes and utensils and all those things, or you use it around the house in your bathroom, it's still a great sponge, no matter where you use it. I have one out in my garage because we're always mopping up some little thing or other. I have them all over the house. And I use sponges. At the sink, I don't like to use cloths. I don't know. Mm-hmm. Some people grew up with dishcloths. I grew up with sponges. So I want to keep doing what I ordinarily do. That's what I do. So I wanted to develop something that made me feel better because you know me. I've been here for 8 years. I've been on television for 15 years. I solve my own problems first.
And yeah, and this is brilliant.
I move on so that I can make sure I can solve other people's problems as well. I want to take it to you, make it easier for you. I don't want extra work. I don't want to have to go out and buy more sponges. I don't want to have to feel like, what am I doing with that horrible thing next to my sink? I want to find the best I can find, and that is my 12 sponges. And one more time, I'm going to say, you don't have to buy 180 sponges once you buy 12 of mine, because every one of my sponge adds up to 15 of these in life.